You know what this is.
We'll play by ear.
Where's all the good music? This is a serious thing.
Yo, actually it is.
There was a lot of music that came out recently, and I asked you, I was like, do you have interest in any of these?
What you gave me, man, was all just poo.
So let me look at the this was last week.
I have been kind of going back though within like the last 2 years and trying to like listen to the shit, but it's been just from like certain artists. You know what I'm saying? Like I've been like going back on like Conway shit, like Conway the Machine.
I listen that much.
Benny the Butcher and shit like that. Like, you know.
Man, okay. This is shit. Let me see what this was.
So yeah, who did you?
Basically, the headliner,
like Uzi or some shit like that.
Yeah, nah. Basically, the headliner was basically Wale. Which, hey, Wale's cool, but he's not like, oh, I'm not excited about a new Wale album. Like, if I hear it and it's cool, like, all right, cool. But like,
all right, so
I'm not looking forward to that. Like, oh shit, new Wale dropped. You know, like,
all right. So actually, that's kind of a perfect example of something I've kind of been thinking about. Just, you know, just on my own or whatever. But some artists, like Wale, I would say, for example, you know, they when they take a lot of time off, and it's like they're still relevant because, like, they may be a character outside of, like, you know, their art in some type of way. You know, like, Wale's, like, big on Twitter and, like, you know, and, like, wrestling and TikTok. Shit like that, you know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, you know, like they find other little shits to, like, you know, where they don't have to do music. But it's like when they drop music, it's like nobody really cares, like, unless you like really, really, really,
yeah,
spit in, or like you get, I guess you got to get like the right features and shit like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, but
like, yeah, like, don't get me wrong, I like Wale, like, he's cool.
Yeah, but like, like you said, I'm not checking for no Wale, and it's because like I haven't heard any Wale in like 7-8 years.
Yeah, and even the ones that I did, it'd be like a couple tracks. Like, it's not like, oh, this whole album is dope, or like this whole, right. I mean, I'm sure there's some, I mean,
and
I'm,
this is no knock just on Wale, right, I mean, there's a lot of artists like that, you know, like, what I'm saying, like they go off, like, the scene.
Most people I feel like are casual listeners, they're not headliners, and all we're getting is headline. My question is, you know, where is like the really good music? You know, some of the
I think at this time, especially
news, you know, like good new shit, we're deprived
for,
right,
for
now.
One, I think we're deprived of new artists.
True.
Because none can really get put on, because like you can't tour, you can't, you know what I'm saying, like through the the ways that like artists get on big time is like not only through, oh, the social media is like great, you know what I'm saying, like they got good management, they, you know what I'm saying, got so and so behind them, they're signing here, signing there. No, it's word of mouth. You know, it's like, oh, I went to this random ass, you know, like show or whatever, and this person opened, you know what I'm saying, and they were fucking dope, you know what I'm saying, like that's how really, you know, or like listening to like other shit, like, okay, I'm not gonna lie, Apple Music is actually really dope with the new music shit.
I do too. I like them too with like the trending. They'll help me find new shit. New
yeah.
Singles, new
singles. I don't really see, like, I don't really shoot for singles because I'm more of an album guy. Because I don't like poppy
right
shit, because I think singles is automatically poppy shit.
Always, but
it's
but
automatically
thing, like,
poppy. You're looking
point,
for
though.
A fucking record.
Where are the albums though?
No, I mean, all right, let's look at what Apple Music has, and just to kind of see where we're at in music today.
The funny part is I'm talking about, like, where are all these great big headliners and shit? Drake put something out like a month ago.
But I mean, like, it wasn't hidden
like
that.
I'm not Drake. I know we've had these takes on Drake, but like, I'm looking for, like, everybody says, you know, who's Kendrick? I feel like he's kind of done this before. Like, To Pimp a Butterfly, he could just say, like, hey, listen to that shit again. It applies.
Yeah.
You know, would I like new music from him? Of
actually,
course.
That's someone that I'm looking forward to, like, hearing from.
Oh, for sure. That,
you know,
favorite artist, like, I'm
Kendrick,
looking forward to that.
Cole came out with that song because he was getting dissed or whatever by No Name, or, you know what I'm saying? Like, and that was kind of addressing something, but that was only, like, literally a moment.
I guess the question is, who are the big names right now?
Well,
who are the big good names? Like, I like Kendrick, obviously. Kanye still, but he's not as active. I would say Big. I mean, yeah, like, I don't know. With rap, you always, like, you know, someone, like, runs some shit for a while. They have their runs.
Like, I would say the last person that kind of had their run was, what, DaBaby? You know what I'm saying? Like, where is DaBaby right now?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I mean, I don't know. Like, I guess like everybody's kind of just chilling.
Too. Well, that's the thing. Like, I wouldn't even mind some of, like, the some mindless some poppy shit. Like, here. Dude, give me some fucking Migos. We haven't had new Migos in 2 years, you know?
Yeah.
Like, I'll take some mindless shit to just put on, hear them rap and rhyme about some random shit, laugh about it, and then move on.
Well, I think, okay, well, all right. So, how about this take? What if those artists
that was a good one.
Don't really feel comfortable in putting out kind of just bullshit records because like there's no substance behind it.
People are,
and it's like
listeners
we
right
can't
now.
You know what I'm saying? Like, first of all, we can go there's nowhere to go to dance. You know what I'm saying? It's not really just a happy time in life, period, for anybody. You know what I'm saying? Black, white, or other, or woman, male, gay, straight, whatever the fuck, you know, like Republican, Democrat, you know, like it's kind of a shitty time for everybody. Like it's a toss up. Everything's in the air, you know? So like, you know, artists don't feel that, you know, like, oh, well, I can't just put out the bullshit ass music. Right. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like
critical listeners now.
Like, yeah, like they're going to be looking for me to say something. You know what I'm saying?
Like,
especially in hip hop.
Yeah, because look, I like
hip hop is pop.
Right. I like Migos. I will never argue for Migos. Because again, I know it's like a guilty pleasure. It's just more of like I like the beats. It's my.
Them niggas go hard though.
Yeah, it's catchy shit. It's catchy shit. You know, so I'd never argue on their behalf. But to your point, like a lot of the reason why I fuck with them is that I'll hear their shit when I'm like chilling with the crew or like I'm out. I have like memories attached to it.
Yeah,
there are no memories to make right now other than just chilling at the house. So like right. I feel you on that, and like
right.
they really don't have a place for their shit to pop off. You know,
exactly, and nobody does. Not even just Migos. See, if Migos can't do it, shit, nobody can really can. But you got artists like DaBaby that, like, you know, 2 weeks ago or whatever, you know what I'm saying? He dropped something, and it was like a total change up in his subject matter. You know what I'm saying? Like, he was actually talking about, like, some real shit. You know what I'm saying? It was, like, conscious in a way. But it was still his style. Still, like, you know what I'm saying? Like it didn't seem like he changed, you know what I'm saying? With a conscious type beat, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, trying to switch it up like that, it was still explode everything, but it was like good shit. You know what I'm saying? It was kind of like listening to like Pac or some shit like that, almost. You know, but it was just DaBaby. It was 2020 shit, and I mean, I think that's where like for the last 2 weeks, there's kind of been like shit that came out. You know what I'm saying? Like since then or whatever. I think people are trying to like, oh. Getting to the pen and pad, like
yeah.
I gotta come hard. You know what I'm saying? Not only just because not for me, but for my people. Like I got something to say. You know, because you know it's always wise to like express your feelings through your art. You know, like
right.
that's the best way you could do it. You know, like that's what Jordan did. You know what I'm saying? Anytime that he was feeling like shit, like personally, he went. Off, he
right.
made you feel fucking good, you know what I'm saying?
Well, you know, it's kind of this might be like a controversial take because I mean, I know people are tired
hey,
of like,
what Don't At Me is about, man. Don't At Me, motherfucker. Fuck
don't off. At Me. You know, we'd be critical of remakes and lack of originality, but I did think it was cool when Nelly came out with the dirty versions. I told you this before, but like just the concept alone, like the album itself, meh, you know, like kind of meh. But
and that was an era though, everyone was coming out with like remix CDs, like whole compilations. Because I remember like So Def did some shit, it was like We Invented the Remix, and Bad Boy had one called that, like you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like it was like every little rap crew or like rap label or some shit like that, like remix they shit.
Well, like you look at somebody like MF Doom. That like MF Doom will release shit like remaster with like the same shit, but like it's a cappella, like the beat's different. And have like, oh, this song, this beat version or whatever. Like I'm like, I don't know what the fucking word means. Like the name, he'll just have like you know, John Doe version. I'm like, right. what?
Yeah.
But like, I'm like, damn, this is like a different song. It makes you listen to the lyrics in a different way when you have a different beat to carry it. So I'm looking for like those creative ones, like recycled music with new beats. Like, why can't Kanye go back and do like a Yeezus reinvented or something like that? Yeezus reborn. Look, there's your name right there.
Well, that's where producers like can step in. Okay, I can actually tell you an artist that is actually doing that shit with like remixes and shit, like songs that he dropped 2 years ago. St. John. I don't know if you ever heard of St. John, but I think he's like from Brooklyn or some shit like that. But his music is like, it's kind of like out there. It's kind of Travis-esque. You know what I'm saying? Like, but it's not Travis. Like, it's a totally different shit. But you wouldn't expect it from this dude. It's kind of trippy shit. You know what I'm saying? A little bit of rock star shit. But he has he re-released, somebody remixed his song Roses. Like, you know, like to a techno version, like, you know, you know what I'm saying? Like, sped the shit up or whatever, you know, with the same lyrics or whatever. But, you know, not too different of a beat, but it has that, you know what I'm saying? He actually dropped a video, like, on his shit with that remix. You know what I'm saying? And also, a few months later, so I guess that was a few months ago or whatever, a couple weeks ago, he dropped the remix, same song, Roses, with Future. Different beat, but you know what I'm saying? So it was kind of like a mid-tempo. Like, it's,
I like when they do that, though. Like, yeah. I liked that when Kanye dropped Life of Pablo, he kept fucking with the tracks after they were out. Like, he kept tweaking it.
That's the thing I kind of don't like. Because I don't like when Tame Impala did that shit to Borderline.
I like the first one better. Sometimes the first one is better, because that first one was better. I don't like that new ending. The new ending it has. Did you? I just wasn't the same.
Yeah, it wasn't hidden. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, so yeah, sometimes it's good, sometimes it's bad. And with DSPs, it's bad. You know what I'm saying? Like, in the LimeWire days, that was cool, because it's like,
oh, you had multiple versions. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But like, in a DSP, they
give me both versions.
Yeah, like, let me keep the version that I already have, because like, if you look at like a playlist that I have, like, one of the Borderline is like blanked out. It still says Borderline Tame Impala, but it's grayed out. You know what I'm saying? I can't click it, whatever the fuck. But I like put the new version, because all they did was repackage the CD.
Yeah,
and, like, it shows you sometimes in Apple Music, like, on your homepage,
can no longer play in this country.
Yeah, like. And it's like, what the fuck? And then you'll see it, like, again.
It
like
skips
new,
it?
Yeah. It'll be like a new, like say if you got, like, an album, and they, like, revamp the whole album. You know what I'm saying? Like, that shit will go away, but you'll see it, like, you just fucking, like, downloaded it. And it's like, what the fuck? I've been having this shit for, like, 2 years. You know? But like,
you know, it's weird. So, Sound of Revenge.
Great album.
For some reason, when I listen to it on my phone, it's edited. I never had the edited version.
Sometimes Apple, my mind does that.
I never had the edited version. And I guess whenever I got, you know, the latest phone and it kind of synced up the album, it always plays unedited. I mean, the edited version. I'm like, wait, I'll go find the song. It'll say explicit. I'll click play next. Edited. I don't know, man. I'm like, is Chameleon Air just like... Oh, I'm righteous. He's going, you know, because like, y'all businessman and shit, you know?
Yeah. Well, yeah, they used to be Christian rappers and shit like that.
Mace.
Yeah, they was on that shit earlier.